We've been enjoying Indian summer for past week or two. It's been, oh Christ, it's been in the high 70s. It's been lovely, lovely weather. My children and my grandchildren, there's, I mean, if they want something, they get it. So I have to make stuff for them that they can't get elsewhere. So what I've done over the past couple of days is I sat down at the wheel and, made some little shapes that hopefully can be turned into coffee mugs. Everybody loves coffee, right? You know, you're going to drink coffee, you don't drink it like they do in Indonesia. It's like, with, you know, like that, you got to have a, handle. So that's what we're going to do today. We take this clay. This clay is probably 10 or 15 years old. But if you keep the goddamn thing wet, it'll last forever. So, diving into this stuff, this is what I use to make these pieces. And, let's see, I need a garage. Lop off about a pound and a half. That should do it. Get her into shape. Now, you might notice my wardrobe is totally Rhonda. She got me these long john things. Got me this thing, and it's 55 degrees, so it's kind of chilly. Gotta have the right clothing for making handles. All right, let me get these out of the way. They could be in serious danger. Manipulated into the proper shape. And you wet the hell out of it. You see the water? Oh, man! Well, I said wet the hell out of it, and that's just what I did. So, anyway. you start doing this thing, which most of you male viewers will be... accustomed to.
That's not right.
Start dragging this baby out. Okay. That's a pretty big handle. Big fat handle. This water aside, and I need a needle tool. Where's the needle tool? Come on, nail. No. Oh, here's one. Needle tool. Let's see, right about Leo. Okay. Just set that aside. Okay, so this handle is going to be thinner and more delicate. Maybe for the mug. Her Her hands are smaller than Johnny's or Kyle's, so we'll make a smaller handle. Okay, we're going to take a brick now. We're going to let those handles dry a little bit. And we're going to have a little music interlude. Handles are drying. The mugs are under wraps over here. I don't know if you can see it, but so anyway. These handles have dried sufficiently to about the same wetness as these mugs. So what we're going to do is handle them. Now that's kind of heavy. I could have trimmed more off of that, but I didn't. So. Handle goes to who? I think that handle looks right from this. So I'm going to score this and this, because that's where I'm going to stick that baby. I'm a little nervous because these handles are wetter than the mug that they're going on to. So maybe I'm doing this prematurely, but let's find out. Smush that baby on there. Some pressure. Rest on there, so that means I gotta get the clay out again. After inspection, I can see you for me. Take a bashful baby and a little maybe. Who's a little baby? That's you. Okay, that's pretty good. Leave it at that. Let that baby dry. And for the next one. Okay, the big big fat bowl. This could be a soup bowl for crying out loud. Reasons, but it's for aesthetics. I just think it would look cool. It would look cool to have a thumb rest right about there. Eyes flit feathers after the struggle. The hope joy on through the mind. So there it is. Now these mugs will need to dry for several days. So all the water is removed and they can be fired. There's still probably 7 or 8 pounds of clay left that I can use if I get so inspired. I like this one. This one's pretty cool. Okay, that's it for tonight. Decoration tomorrow, I guess.
This was a mistake to be filmed.